Rubisi Ramirez, gold medalist in London 4 years ago at flyweight, and seeking to join George Finnegan of the United States and Hungary's István Kovács as the only athletes to have claimed Olympic medals in both fly and bantamweight divisions.
Please welcome the boxer in the blue corner, representing Uzbekistan.
Recebam também o pugilista que ficará no canto azul, representante do Uzbekistão, Murodjon Ahmadaliyev.
Just 21 years old and seen as one of the rising stars of the bantamweight category. Silver medalist in last year's World Championships in Qatar, Murodjon Ahmadaliyev. Uzbekistan have a very strong record in the Olympics, not least here in Rio.
There's the whiff of cordite in the air here. This feels like a big one, doesn't it?
Introducing the boxer in the red corner, representing Cuba.
Apresentando o pugilista no canto vermelho, que representa Cuba, Robinson Dani.
Showed phenomenal talent as a youngster. As he's grown, he's got better and better, Ramirez.
Representing Uzbekistan.
E apresentando o pugilista no canto azul, que representa o Uzbekistão, Murodjon Ahmadaliyev.
Ahmadaliyev made his World Series debut this year, which included a defeat to his opponent here, Ramirez,
who was almost untouchable in that particular competition. But a couple of great results already for Ahmadaliyev.
Second semi-final of the men's bantamweight division for the right to figure in the gold medal bout against Shakur Stevenson of the United States of America, who walked over his scheduled opponent in the first semi-final, Russia's Nikitin, who failed a medical check. Ahmadaliyev, southpaw from Uzbekistan, in the blue, against Ramirez of Cuba.
I wonder if it will be a case of somebody deciding to make a change to the style here and think about upsetting the plan of the other by switching. We shall see.
Well, we've seen several occasions in the ring in these Rio games where opponents have shaken the Cuban stylists out of their normal rhythm. He's aggressive, Ahmadaliyev, strong puncher.
This is high quality stuff, both ways.
Well, you said the anticipation was keen for this one. Looks like it's going to live up to its semi-final billing. A little low there, referee didn't intervene.
Yeah, that was the point Ramirez made. It was on the border, as they say. Great left from an acute angle and replied in kind by Ahmadaliyev. They're not having much trouble finding each other, are they? Brilliant, absolutely brilliant start to this.
And both have landed with some clean shots.
Fantastic.
Lovely switch from head to body there from Ramirez. Good defense from the Cuban as well with, yeah, the high gloves.
Well spotted, and it just got Ahmadaliyev off balance for the first time in the contest. There's telling left in that exchange, and Ramirez, I thought, just wobbled slightly. Okay, now.
Two strong left hooks there from Medaliev. Tremendous first round.
That could be one of the best rounds of the entire tournament here in Rio.
Couldn't disagree with that. He did appear to be just momentarily rocked by the first of those two left hands from Medaliev. Looking to be a back-to-back Olympic gold medalist, Ramirez, after winning the flyweight class 4 years ago in London, now in this bantamweight semi-final against this dangerous opponent from Uzbekistan, Medaliev. All three for the Cuban, Ramirez, after round one.
Seconds out. Round two.
Second round of this bantamweight semi-final, scheduled for three. And the lead for the Cuban in red, Ramirez, against Medaliev of Uzbekistan.
Another ferocious start here.
Keep the head up, both of you. Stop! Hey, keep the head up now.
Medaliev looks like a fellow who gives the heavy bag a very hard time in the gym, and I would imagine he's got the face of Ramirez pinned onto it when he's working away.
Watch your head.
A reminder, the boxer in blue, Medaliev, lost to Ramirez in the World Series. Good work from both men at close quarters here. Tremendous fight.
Yeah. When you watch big time boxing and events of the quality of this, it stretches out in time in your mind. It's unbelievable, but you know, we'll go away from this session looking back over moments in this fight, and we're not even halfway through it yet. Oh, brilliant, absolutely wondrous.
Superb timing there from Ramirez. Medaliev trying to respond. Well, they look like two professionals in there, and I'm pretty sure very soon they will be.
They are two young men who could go on to become anything, anything at all in world boxing. They're that talented.
Ramirez getting the judge's eye unanimously after that first round. Appears to me he's landed the cleaner blows of this second. A lot of Medaliev's work again there, just being caught on the arms and the gloves of the Cuban.
Needs to watch out for that little sneaky uppercut from Medaliev though.
Trying to bully Ramirez, who refuses to yield. It's one of those fights where you almost want to switch your microphone off and just
stand and scream.
Let it go.
Stand and scream like everybody else in the hall here. Just behind us here, we have Acelino Freitas, the great Brazilian star of the 1990s, the kind of war he was often in, which made him a household name in Brazil. It's that good.
If you ever wondered about the effort that you need to put into boxing, just look at the figure of that Medaliev on his stool after 6 minutes. Ramirez takes it unanimously again. Handsome lead for the Cuban into the third and final round.
Round three.
Ever so slightly, the more accurate and incisive with his punching Ramirez. That's probably what's shading it. When Akhmedeliev sat down on his stool, he looked quite shot-worn suddenly, didn't he, around his face. He's taken a lot of punishment.
Well, to all intents and purposes, Akhmedeliev in blue of Uzbekistan needs a knockout in this third and final round.
And it may be that the battery is starting to run down a little bit. He's not quite got the fervour of the first two rounds so far in this one. Trudging forward now rather than jumping forward. The greatest thing about Ramirez for me, he can fight on the inside and on the outside.
He's a very savvy fighter, Ramirez.
This is an artist at work here.
Of course, keep the head up, okay? All for you.
1 minute 30 is all he's got left now, Akhmedeliev. Running short of ideas, running short of time.
This is one of the potential rising stars, remember, in blue, Akhmedeliev in this bantamweight division, but I think he's just been shown today that the route to the very summit is still an arduous one to climb.
Watch the back.
Still has a puncher's chance in there. As I say, he's going to need that knockout.
What's great from the Cuban point of view, I think, as well, is that there's no sign that Ramirez is starting to run out of gas. And remember, this is his fourth contest in the tournament.
Good point.
For all the ability and all the preparation, sometimes the Cuban's opponents do tend to think, well, you never know, the party lifestyle is very tempting, and once or twice they have gone slightly off message, but it doesn't appear to be the case in this tournament with Ramirez.
This boy is fit and focused and heading for a gold medal bout. I mean, technically, from this Cuban fighter Ramirez, that has been top of the tree. Fabulous performance. He knows he's won. Akhmedeliev came to try and bully him, but he refused to take the approach that the Uzbek had in mind. And virtually all of the class he worked with, great respect to Akhmedeliev, who's a medalist here. Ramirez was fantastic.
And look at the respect in the Uzbeki supporters, who are used to winning, remember. That was an absolute privilege to witness.
Well, in our fullest expectation that Ramirez has taken this, what a final in the bantamweight division. It potentially one of the great fights here at the Rio Games.
The winner by unanimous decision.
Senhoras e senhores, o vencedor por decisão unânime no canto vermelho.
Robesi Ramirez of Cuba, unanimous points win over Murodjon Akhmedeliev of Uzbekistan in the gold medal bout against another tremendous fighter from the USA, Shakur Stevenson, a final.